is in store for us now. We're going to check in with our chief meteorologist, Tom Tasselmeyer. Tom?
Okay, Rod, we've been watching this storm system since last night, all week long, really. It pretty much followed the path we thought it would follow and did most of what we thought as far as precipitation, but the temperatures were warmer than normal, warmer than we expected, and pushed all the way west of Baltimore. What we expected to happen on the eastern shore crossed the bay and came here. And so we ended up with more rain than snow, the end result, because the high today was well above freezing. We expected temperatures would be above freezing, but not as much as we saw today. In fact, many areas actually hit 40 degrees around Baltimore, and that made its way all the way back into Washington County to our west. Well, much chillier than normal day. 50 is the normal high, though, so with temperatures in the 30s, it was a rather chilly and raw March day. 3/4 of an inch total precipitation so far, and it's still precipitation falling in some areas. For the year now, we've had over 6 inches, and that gets us about 1/4 inch below normal. 10 inches of snow on this day back in 1962. We were just talking about the blizzard of 62, however, and how it's not unusual to have these powerful coastal storms this time of year that produce rain and snow. And the one in 62 was the strongest of the 20th century, producing upwards of 40 inches of snow in the Blue Ridge Mountains of Virginia and 70 mile an hour winds at Ocean City. Really damaging windstorm and snowstorm 51 years ago today. So this one's sort of following in that footstep of that one many years ago. Up on the upper eastern shore, we still have a winter weather advisory, as well as for Dorchester, Wicomico, and Somerset counties, because there is the potential, as the storm is moving away, these eastern shore locations could see the rain change over to a little bit of accumulating snow. The main issue for the overnight, though, will be the winds. We've got these blue shaded areas showing wind advisories going through the overnight hours and wind warnings along the coast. The winds have been gusting to 30 and even 40 miles an hour at times, 44 mile an hour wind gust at the Patuxent Naval Air Station. Salisbury had a thunderstorm earlier today with a gust to 56 miles an hour. It's currently gusting to 39. So windy and blustery conditions through the evening hours. Those onshore winds and heavy rain causing coastal flood warnings down at Ocean City. We had reports of some flooding at 7th and Pleasure Streets earlier this afternoon. The swirl of clouds offshore, that's the center of the storm, and it will gradually pull away. On the western side, it will get a little bit colder, and that's why some snow could still mix with the rain showers as they taper off tonight. And behind it, high pressure will try to kick this thing out, but one last gasp likely to come down the coast on Friday. So overnight tonight, watch for icy patches. Some spots could dip into the upper 20s. So if you have some slush left over on your porch, your sidewalk, or even on decks around the region, it could get a little slick overnight. Then during the day tomorrow, we'll see some sun mixed with the clouds and temperatures still below normal, 40 to 45 and feeling chilly with a northwest wind at 10 to 20 miles an hour. But if you're hoping for spring and you're tired of all this messy wintry weather, well, look forward, because after Friday's rain and snow showers, we break out into sunshine and warm things up. 50s for highs over the weekend and into the low 60s by next Monday.